Richard Hannay, you have got into the wrong ditch, my friend, and you had better climb out.
Thank you. Paddock, that's me home. I'll be heading out for dinner.
I'll speak to you. May I come in for a minute? Is the door locked? I'm very sorry. It's a mighty liberty, but you look like the kind of man who would understand. I've had you in my mind all this week when things got troublesome. Say, will you do me a good turn?
I'll listen to you. That's all I'll promise.
Pardon. I'm a bit rattled tonight. You see, I happen at this moment to be dead.
What does it feel like?
I'm not mad. Yet. Say, sir, I've been watching you, and I reckon you're a cool customer. I reckon, too, you're an honest man and not afraid of playing a bold hand. I'm going to confide in you. I need help worse than any man ever needed it. I want to know if I can count you in.
Get on with your yarn and I'll tell you.
On the 15th day of June, Constantine Karolides is coming to this city. The British Foreign Office has taken to having international tea parties, and the biggest of them is due on that date. Now, Karolides is reckoned the principal guest, and if my friends have their way, he will never return to his admiring countrymen.
Well, that's simple enough, anyhow. You can warn him and keep him at home.
And play their game. If he does not come, they win, for he's the only man that can straighten out the tangle. And if his government are warned, he won't come, for he does not know how big the stakes will be on June the 15th.
What about the British government? They're not going to let their guests be murdered. Tip them the wink, and they'll take extra precautions.
No good. They might stuff your city with plainclothes detectives and double the police, and Constantine would still be a doomed man. He'll be murdered by an Austrian, and there'll be plenty of evidence to show the connivance of the big folk in Vienna and Berlin. It will all be an infernal lie, of course, but the case will look black enough to the world. But it's not going to come off if there's a certain man alive right here in London on the 15th day of June. And that man is going to be your servant, Franklin P. Scudder.
Where did you find out this story?
I completed my evidence 10 days ago in Paris. I can't tell you the details now, for it's something of a history. But when I was quite sure in my own mind, I judged it my business to disappear. And I reached this city by a mighty queer circuit. Till yesterday, I thought I had muddied my trail some. and was feeling pretty happy. Then I saw a man standing in the street outside this block. I used to stay close in my room all day, and only slip out after dark for an hour or two. I watched him for a bit from my window. I thought I recognized him. He came in and spoke to the porter. When I came back from my walk last night, I found a card in my letterbox. It bore the name of the man I want least to meet on God's earth.
What did you do next?
I realized I was bottled as sure as a pickled herring, and that there was only one way out. I had to die. If my pursuers knew I was dead, they would go to sleep again.
How did you manage it?
I had had you in my mind all day, and there seemed nothing to do but to make an appeal to you. I watched from my window till I saw you come home, and then slipped down the stair to meet you. There, sir. I guess you know about as much as me of this business.
Hand me your key, and I'll take a look at the corpse. Excuse my caution, but I'm bound to verify a bit if I can.
I reckon you'd ask for that. But I haven't got it. It's on my chain on the dressing table. I had to leave it behind, for I couldn't leave any clues to breed suspicions. The gentry who are after me are pretty bright-eyed citizens. You'll have to take me on trust for the night, and tomorrow you'll get the proof of the corpse business right enough.
Right. I'll trust you for the night. I'll lock you into this room and keep the key. Just one word, Mr. Scudder. I believe you're straight, but if so be you are not, I should warn you that I'm a handy man with a gun.
I haven't the privilege of your name, sir. But let me tell you that you're a true gentleman. Now, I'll thank you to lend me a razor.
My hat, Mr. Scudder.
Not Mr. Scudder. Captain Theopolis Digby of the 40th Gurkhas. Presently home on leave. I'll thank you to remember that, sir.